From Argentina, we welcome Fernando Piñero. Hola, Fernando. Tell us a little bit more about your school and your thoughts about this Global Hangout.
Thank you very much for this invitation. It's a wonderful opportunity. The Escuela de Musica Shinichi Suzuki in Córdoba started more than 50 years ago, actually. Córdoba was one of the first places where Suzuki method was going to be applied in all of the Americas. And I was a Suzuki student myself back in the 70s. So our school right now, we try to cover from the very early stages, 3-4 years old, even earlier, until they get into a professional life. Many people who were previously in our school, they are now playing in professional orchestras all over the places in Argentina and also in other countries. We think at the beginning is when you teach the violin or flute or recorder or viola, whatever, is the idea of resonance, right? Play with a full tone, make music really from your heart. But when you are teaching something like that, you're not just teaching music, you're not just teaching do something. It's also a metaphor. When you're teaching how to produce sound, what you are saying is, tell me who you are through your vibration, through your instrument. And so when I see kids who are now 18 years old or 20, 25 or 30, is that they keep those pillars that were given at an early stage, but then it resonates in a different way in the outer world. A couple of years ago, when we were performing in Brussels, I asked one professor from the Brussels Conservatoire, what do you look for when you are at an exam, the admissions exam? What are you looking for? And he said, what I look at the exam is if the person has an own voice and if they have something to say. And the second part is how do they cope with stress? In 2013, we were invited to France with our kids to a festival musique universitaire. And our students were not university levels, they were teenagers. So something that was very important for me was to, what is the message that I want to convey through my music, through our performance? So our program was a dialogue between classical music, or let's say academic, I don't like that word, but classical music, and the music from the Rio de la Plata, from Argentina, Uruguay, etc. Because there are many connections and there's a very strong influence in all the music by Piazzolla, for example. By the way, Piazzolla went to Paris to study with Nadia Boulanger, and he wanted to be like Stravinsky, he wanted to be like Ravel, but he became Piazzolla. So for me, it's very important to recover, to look again at those old recordings and to bring some of the, some flavor that was there in the 50s and 60s into our performance and do something with that. I definitely think that we have to take a closer look at our roots. Me, not only as a musician, but as an educator, I want our students to have been able to play music from Argentina, music from Uruguay, and also music from other places, because this is one of my interests, you know, how do you develop your own voice, your own ideas? And I think that Global Hangout was an excellent answer because many things were there. You were really ready to the next step, which we don't know yet, but Dean and the entire team, they had an extraordinary background. And I really, really think that this kind of project is like a cutting edge. It's like a, wow, it's wonderful in terms of exploring new possibilities and new horizons.